Okay, so today we have a familiar pattern. We have consolidation here with almost resistance at 900. Let's see if this will be retesting and then breaks to the downside and potentially go down to 800, or if holds support here and move higher. Okay, so price held support here initially. Let's see if can hold the breakout of previous high and go higher, or this will just lead for a breakdown. Slow open at the moment. Okay, so price failed to hold here at the high. Let's see now if this resistance now can hold and we have a leg lower. Otherwise, we'll just hold support here at pivot point and we'll go back up. Okay, so price held support here at 88 and pivot point, then broke out 900s, retested it and held support, now rallying higher. Let's see if this can lead us today at 11,000. Okay, so this is familiar to yesterday's price action at the European Cash Open. Price spiked hard with volume spike. Then this is a natural pullback after this volume spike, but then the question is, will it hold here? Seems like it had. Let's see now if we have a second leg to the higher high. So we have some dollar weakness now, and so euro dollar rallying. This is kind of lagging the index. Let's see if this reverse and the index spikes up fast. Okay, that pullback was fast and bigger than expected. Let's see now if this pivot point will hold the index to go back up. Otherwise, we'll find resistance here at 900s and we'll go further downside. But on the 5 minute here, you can see that
Target
once entered this initial balance of yesterday, found support. So let's see if this can lead the index now up. Otherwise, this will be very bearish. But again, yesterday, once it entered this area, always found support. Let's see if this is the case today as well. Okay, so I reversed the positions. Very clear resistance here. Let's see if this support doesn't hold and this doesn't happen, then price will just go downwards. Okay, so just to see a little bit the importance of this 927 level. Every time price touch this level, had a reversal, but at the moment failed twice to hold it, to break it out. Let's see if it can break it and go initially at yesterday's high and then at 11,000 eventually. But again, as I said yesterday, we have entered a kind of intraday swing zone here, and as soon as this stays in this type of trading, we should expect. Otherwise, if this break out, then we'll have hopefully a different style. But at the moment, this could be for limited expectations. Again, we have FOMC minutes this afternoon, so price action might be limited the whole day today. So we better have limited expectations. So this pattern happened today: initial rally, then resistance, then pullback here at pivot point. Almost broke it out, but that was just a fake down. Then rallied back above here, day's open price in 900s. This is coincides, this is very good support here. Then now let's see if this is gonna break it hard to the upside, and hopefully later in the day or until the first hour of cash market open, we'll visit 11,000. Let's see if this is gonna be a very good short though. Okay, so actually chopping around this area here, pivot point and 900s. Let's see now if we finally go more downside, initially at 800s. This is like a head and shoulders pattern if you try to see it this way. So now if this breaks to the downside, then we'll have a possible move down to 800s. Let's see how this will play out. So as I said earlier, not much can be anticipated today because of FOMC. So let's see how this will go during the US Open.
Just in the current geopolitical climate, just one interesting thing to be.
Okay, so the big picture held help us identify the support here. Then support retested once more and price rallied back up. Then it was choppy. Now almost retested, broke out 900s. Then held support. Then broke out equilibrium line. Then retested and held support. Now spiked up. Let's see now if this can lead the index up to 11,000, and let's see if 11,000 will be a good short. Otherwise, this will just trade downwards and then at these levels. Okay, so now look at this initial rally, found resistance here, then pulled back and found support at this very important level, 927. Let's see now if it can break out and rally more. Okay, so price looks like kind of double topped here. This was sold off back with a volume spike. Let's see now if this initial balance high hold the price and price trade below, or if it's gonna rally up to 11,000. We have US building permits in 10 minutes, so let's see how this will react. Okay, so as I was saying earlier in this video, yesterday when price moved in this area, didn't trade at all and then found support. This was the case today as well. Now price rallied above and close to above yesterday's high and close to 11,000. From an intraday perspective, this could be a very good short, but it could be a very good short from a macro perspective. Let's say you short here for the next, let's say, 5 days until next week, but then it's better to wait for the FOMC tonight and then do it. This is the 200-day moving average right here. Then if you try to build a short here and here, then you could have a kind of pullback, let's say 7,800 or even lower. Then this depends on the way you try to risk your capital and the way you build your positions. But at the moment, I'm building a short position, likely in this area. And what I would like to see is price trading here and then breaks to the downside. So we have a 11,000 failure. So if this kind of, we have this kind of move and then fails to hold and then tomorrow is going is trades below. And then breaks down this area here and then moves even lower. I will try to hit my first targets at this area here, 10,680, and then hopefully for a lower price, like 10,500 again. And then I will look if I will buy it short, if I will buy it long for with this kind of support. From Monday's low price for a potential rally. Otherwise, I will just wait to see how price will play out here and if it's gonna break to the upside. But again, we will need to see the FOMC minutes because we might have a spike up and then a resistance and then a sell-off. So let's see how this will play out. And from an intraday perspective, found resistance here at resistance one, but then let's see if 11,000 being retested off, or if this just go downside. Okay, so DAX pulled back inside the initial balance zone from today's session. Let's see now, we have a kind of divergence here. SPY rallied aggressively and gapped up and rallied that from 206, almost 207 yesterday's high, but DAX didn't do that. But if you think yesterday DAX closed 2.5% up and SPY almost 0%, so I think SPY is catching up yesterday's, let's say, correlation with DAX. Let's see now if this can lead us up to 11,000 or just collapse back down. Okay, so price look like held support here at 27s, then broke out in sell balance high. Let's see now how will behave here at the US cash open price. Okay, so euro dollar at the moment made a new low for the day. SPY have a, let's say, a trend up to 207. Let's see how this will play out during the FOMC, if there's anything new. But again, I said here that this one could be a very good short opportunity and price might go lower from here. So let's see how this will play out during the FOMC and if price spikes up here and then sells downside, or if it just go above 11,000, hold above and then make a new high.